In Greater Manchester, there are 92 jobs currently being dealt with, and in the past hour, control have received over 290 new calls.
Ambulance service, is a patient breathing?
Yeah, I've just dropped a paving stone on my foot.
Ambulance, is the patient breathing?
She's breathing okay, but she certainly couldn't get off the bus. She's almost in a catatonic state, but she's not with it. You never know what you're going to meet when you go out, do you?
He's falling off the ladder on the concrete on the path in the garden.
What was he doing up the ladder?
Hanging basket. Oh. I told him not to do it.
Right, well, they don't listen, though, do they?
They don't, no.
Is the patient breathing?
Just.
Tell me exactly what's happened.
He's getting heart pains in his shoulders. He's only just got out of hospital. He had a heart attack.
Right. Don't leave him alone till the ambulance crew's right there, okay?
Ambulance is coming there, Dad.
Yeah, it says chest pain, but it says shoulder pain, recent heart attack. So I'm presuming it's feeling the same as last time.
Ellie and Ian are the closest crew to the priority call in progress. They're 6 minutes away.
Is he changing colour?
He's a very pale colour.
Is he clammy or having cold sweats?
He's very cold.
Can you wake him up?
Dad? This one, there you are.
Okay then.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
Thank you.
When did you have his heart attack? When did
you have? 2nd of May.
2nd of May.
Len, just sit forward for me and just go and have a little listen to your chest.
When did you last have your heart attack? You just had the one?
No, he's at
four.
Just do your temperature, okay? It goes in your ear.
They must quickly assess Leonard to see if he is at risk of another heart attack.
He's had a heart attack as well, he's never known he's having them.
He's never known?
No.
She's never had any pain?
Nothing.
No. Have you found out then what's happened?
It's been like this.
Look at that, his blood pressure's in his boots, 78.55.
Yeah, what was his temp?
He's really cold. I won't give up.
There's something going on. You do sing crackly as well. So it's another trip back up to the hospital then.
With a dangerously low blood pressure, Ellie and Ian decide to take Leonard to the nearest A&E, 4 miles away, where he can be seen by cardiac specialists.
You all right, Lem?
Yep.
Lem? You okay? Ella? Lem? Ella?
He's gone.
Yeah, he's gone. Lem?
Tip him back. Lem? Wheel.
Go on,
Len. All right. Len.
What's up with him?
Don't know, just share. Just give us a second. Two rests.
Go on, Lem. Go on, Lem. Go on, Lem. Go on, Lem. Go Go on, Len.
Get another 12 lead done.
Len? You all right? Yeah? No pain anywhere? No. Scared us all then, pal.
That wasn't a fighting episode. That lasted too long.
Yeah, no, it wasn't, no. No. Right, you jump on. Yeah.
Dad, arm are you?
Yeah.
You okay? Bit of a scare. No worries. He's not well. No. He's not well at all.
My granddad, unfortunately, he was given 2 weeks to live and he died on the 3rd of October. Watching him in so much pain, I used to pray that they'd take him, because he did suffer. The day that he died, my heart broke, but I also felt at peace that he weren't suffering anymore. I felt just all that pain go out of him, and just at peace. We all do have to die one day. Some people go to work and never come back and you never got to say goodbye. The best way to go is surrounded by all your loved ones holding your hand. That is the best way you can die. And that's what you got.
Just been in to resource and our guy went into cardiac arrest. They don't think he's going to make it through the day.
His wife's absolutely devastated, isn't she?
I've just been speaking to her. I feel like crying, don't I?
They're the worst ones. When it happens like that, they go off on you and you think you've got them back and then that happens. What a shame. Such a nice fella.
He's so, so sad.
It is.
I've surprised myself how well I'm doing, but it's hard. Like, I think of him all the time. Yeah. Just learning to adjust without him is my next step. He knew who I was and he knew it was a caring person. And he just loved that I was a paramedic. He was so proud. He always taught me it's okay not to be okay. And it's okay to suffer. It's okay to have a mental health illness like PTSD. You know, you're human. Like, I don't change role. I don't put on my uniform and I turn into a different person. I am who I am. I am me. Take me as I am.
Forget everything and remember, for everything a reason. You got the feeling. You got the feeling. You got the feeling.